proves that any organism with sufficient mass and cognitive capability is a potential factor. Is something wrong?
No, nothing.
Splendid, shall we? Unfortunately, my usefulness to this particular endeavor has come to an end. Protocol does not allow units with my classification to perform a task as important as the reunification of the Index with the Core. That final step is reserved for you, Reclaimer.
Cortana.
I've spent the last 12 hours cooped up in here watching you toady about, helping that thing get set to slit our throats.
Hold on now. He's a friend.
Oh, I didn't realize. He's your pal, is he? Your chum? Do you have any idea what that bastard almost made you do?
Yes. Activate Halo's defenses and destroy the Flood, which is why we brought the Index to the control center.
You mean this?
A construct. In the Core? That is absolutely unacceptable.
Sod off!
What impertinence! I shall purge you at once!
You sure that's a good idea?
How dare you? I'll...
Do what? I have the Index. You can just float and sputter.
Enough! The Flood is spreading. If we activate Halo's defenses, we can wipe them out.
You have no idea how this ring works, do you? Why the Forerunners built it? Halo doesn't kill Flood. It kills their food. Humans, Covenant, whatever. We're all equally edible. The only way to stop the Flood is to starve them to death. And that's exactly what Halo is designed to do. Wipe the galaxy clean of all sentient life. You don't believe me? Ask him.
Is it true?
More or less. Technically, this installation's pulse has a maximum effective radius of 25,000 light years. But once the others follow suit, this galaxy will be quite devoid of life. Or at least any life with sufficient biomass to sustain the Flood. But you already knew that. I mean, how couldn't you?
Left out that little detail, did he?
We have followed outbreak containment procedure to the letter. You were with me each step of the way as we managed this crisis.
Chief, I'm picking up movement.
Why would you hesitate to do what you've already done?
We need to go. Right now.
Last time you asked me, if it were my choice, would I do it? Having had considerable time to ponder your query, my answer has not changed. There is no choice. We must activate the ring.
Get us out of here.
If you are unwilling to help, I will simply find another. Still, I must have the Index. Give your construct to me, or I will be forced to take her from you.
That's not going to happen.
So be it. Save his head. Dispose of the rest.
Look out!
Sorry, I'm late. My hot chocolate boiled over.
We can't let the monitor activate Halo. We have to stop him. We have to destroy Halo. According to my analysis of the available data, I believe the best course of action is somewhat distant. An explosion of sufficient size will help to stabilize the ring, and will cut through a number of primary systems. We need to trigger a detonation on a large scale, however. The Starship's fusion reactor is going critical to do the job. I'm going to search what's left of the Covenant battleship and see if I can locate the Pillar of Autumn's crash site. If the ship's fusion reactors are still relatively intact, we can use them to destroy Halo.
I wasn't joking when I said that earlier. My hot chocolate actually boiled over in the microwave.
Yeah.
Huge mess.
I believe you.
I crash site yet. We need to buy some time in case the monitor or his sentinels find a way to activate Halo's final weapon without the index. The machinery in these tanks are Halo's primary firing mechanism. They consist of three phase pulse generators that amplify Halo's signal and allow it to fire deep into space. The power levels are enormous. Can't even begin to calculate the pulse's range. So, if we damage or destroy these generators, the monitor will need to repair them before Halo can be used. That should buy us some time.
That makes sense.
I'm marking the location of the nearest pulse generator with a nav point. We need to move in and neutralize the device.
I got stuck. Also, I think it's kind of funny that Cortana uses British slang with an American accent.
Yeah.
Remember there being... Yeah, there it is. This should help with the tank.
It's already did.
Oh. Well, it would help if the tank was still there. How about that? Why don't you just stand on the big glowy beam? I'm walking back out, by the way.
Oh, and you have killed me.
That's my bad, sorry. I did not want to get in this ship with an out. That's kind of neat. Did you hear what one of the grunts said?
Nope.
Bad cyborg. But you know, cyborg is an accurate descriptor.
here.
That said, unless I'm mistaken, most of the augmentations are actually chemicals and not mechanical implants or whatever. I think he only really qualifies for cyborg because he's got a computer chip in his head and that's about it.
And ceramic plating on his skeleton.
Is that cybernetics though?
Not really. But it's certainly not a chemical change.
Yeah. I feel like there might be an argument to be made there, but I do not have the knowledge to make it.
Oh, that's a rocket launcher guy.
Yeah. I also had a rocket launcher, though.
Well, you're not the one who shot me, I would assume.
Nope, I'm not. I was a little scary to think about, but he almost killed me, and I might have picked up your shotgun ammo.
Yep, that is what you did.
Sorry. But at least I killed the rocket float. I found the exit.
I found a new shotgun.
What? We've never been here before. Okay, that's one of them.
Almost dead.
Hmm. Alright, I got the Banshees. I think it's pretty impressive that Bungie was able to make a game so good that it still holds up today.
Like, yeah.
The graphics are obviously dated.
But it's the gameplay loop.
It's been long enough that the remastered graphics are starting to update. But the game is fun.
Yeah. Core gameplay loop is still fine.
Place for me to be right now. It's remarkably difficult for the Wraith to shoot me, apparently.
I'm dead.
Okay, well, I got the Banshee. And the Wraith. Wow. I shot at a jackal and all of the pellets did like a cartoon thing where they went around it. None of them even hit the shield.
That is kind of funny.
There's a warthog here.
Okay, I'll be there in a second.
Huh. The ice is slippery.
Yep.
I think it's kind of neat. Benches. All right, let's go. I'm in. that was really effective.
That did it. The pulse generator overloaded.
I'm gonna say you're probably lucky that flood guy decided to punch you because he was holding a rocket launcher.
Okay. I'm also unlucky that he decided to punch me the instant the shields went down.
Yeah, that is a bit of a stroke of bad luck. Yeah, let's get out of here.
There are two rocket floods. I think I killed both of them, but I'm dead.
Okay. I'm suspicious. Did you respawn?
Yeah.
Okay. I got out of my ship a little too aggressively. You got your stuff?
No, but it's too far. I'm not going back right now.
Okay.
Is that like the entrance to the tunnel?
Guess that door's not all the way open.
Yeah. think I just got killed by a rocket flood.
Yeah, that does appear to be about what happened. Wow! He's quick on the draw. Ghosts here, I'm getting in one.
Okay. It killed the banshees, so.
Okay. It would appear that there were a couple rocket flood. At least that's what it looked like just then. Yeah. There were two. Nice.
But you...
Sorry. Got one of the tanks down.
Got the other one.
Hunters.
getting in this Banshee and flying away.
Okay.
Get neutralized. Let's get out of here.
All right.
Let's find a ride and get to the captain.
No, that'll take too long.
You have a better idea?
There's a teleportation grid that runs throughout Halo. That's how the monitor moves about so quickly. I learned how to tap into the grid when I was in the control center. Unfortunately, each jump requires a rather consequential expenditure of energy.
Something tells me I'm not gonna like this.
But I'm pretty sure I can pull it from your suit without permanently damaging. Needless to say, I think we should only try this.